Hey everybody, it's Jeff Beers here from 40 Finance, and today I have a topic perfect for February 2019. I'm going to be looking at three dating stocks today and telling you if I think it's a buy, sell, or hold situation. If you like this type of content, please subscribe to the channel, like it, share with your friends. Let's jump in. Okay, so the first company that we're going to look at is called the Match Group. And the Match Group is a portfolio of brands that hold some of the biggest names in online dating today. Names like Match.com, Tinder, OkCupid, Plenty of Fish, and several others. They also have a contingent of specialty sites such as BlackPeopleMeet.com and some religious dating sites as well. Match Group by far is the biggest name in the industry. Let's take a look at their stock fundamentals. Okay, so as you see right here, Match Group's currently trading at $54.73. They have a current PE ratio of $45.80 and a forward PE of 32.58. Over the past 5 years, Match has done very well, particularly as Tinder grew and they acquired Tinder. They did not invent it themselves, they bought it. And since that time, profits have really been looking great. You see here in approximately 2018, they had a huge spike and things have been going very well. The forward PE tells us that profitability is going to continue to rise. However, right now, there's not a lot of speculation for capital gains for the Match Group. I looked around at some analyst targets. They're not very big. They're somewhere in the neighborhood of 5 to 10% growth this year. But from a long-term perspective, if you believe in online dating, Match Group is pretty much the best of breed when it comes to a dedicated dating stock. Next up, we have a much smaller company with Spark Networks. You see they have Elite Singles, J-Date, Christian Mingle, Silver Singles. Spark Network is really vested in sort of niche sites, having a portfolio of niche sites that appeal specifically to folks who have identified, you know, who they're looking for. So, you know, Silver Singles, for example, is going to be a 55 and up type dating platform. They're attacking the industry with a personalization approach to try to get people exactly what they want and not have to sort through thousands and thousands of profiles that aren't going to appeal to them. Here you see for Spark Networks, right now they're trading at $9.50. They've been as far down as penny stock territory. However, they've had a big event happen in and around 2017 where the future for Spark Networks looked demonstrably better and investors started to pay attention. Thus, you see a huge spike here that capped out somewhere in the neighborhood of $15. Before, you know, a little bit of a downturn coming back to $9.40. From a PE ratio, it's important to note that Spark Networks is not profitable yet. And that's not really a surprise at this price range at $9.50 a share. However, they are growing earnings. They're not expected to be profitable in 2019. I'm not sure exactly how close they are to the profitable threshold, but they are making strides. And you'll see in comparison to Match Network, they are probably much more likely to see capital gains in their stock price this year. You can see a one-year target on the Yahoo Network puts them at 1534. So if you're looking for something in a more short-term environment where you might get quick turnaround of money, Spark Networks offer some opportunity as opposed to Match, which is probably going to lay pretty flat unless there's some huge news in the industry. Okay, I pulled this stat here just to give you a sort of concept of where Match sits with the competitors, right? Like Spark, and there's another stock I did not list here called the Meet Group, which I just didn't really think that there was a lot there to talk about, but you can look it up on your own. This is the most popular online dating apps in the United States as of December 2017. So the data is a year old. However, I couldn't find anything newer that went into this deep of a study. And you see the contestants, if you will. You have Tinder, Plenty of Fish, Match, OkCupid, Grindr, and Bumblebee. Of the top four, and I put M's by them, they're all owned by Match Group, okay? And the secondary competitors down there, I put P because they're privately owned, okay? There's no way to play them in the stock market. So right now, at least from an industry perspective, if you're long on the industry and you believe that internet dating will continue to evolve, and as you know, an internet generation continues to get a few years older, if you believe in that, then right now in the market, there's no one better than Match. Absolutely not. The only question is how much growth can we expect to see in online dating? And I think in the United States, you're going to have your sort of normal 10 to 15% growth, but internationally, there might be an opportunity for more. However, a lot of the growth that I saw was just doing some basic research is over in the Far East. So China, Japan, those countries have their own suite of apps that relate to dating. One that was seemingly very popular in China was called Momo, M-O-M-O, which is a publicly traded stock. I didn't feel like it fit the precise dating market that we're attacking here. I'm also personally not very big on investing in Chinese stocks from an individual investment standpoint. I do have exposure in ETFs, but if you're interested in that, you definitely want to check out Momo. But here in the United States, right now I say it's Match or nothing. If you want to get into Spark Networks, the risk is going to be higher. The gains are likely going to be higher. So that may be a way to play the market and get a quick return. But there is one caveat here that's coming down the pipe that I think everyone should know about. I said this presentation was about three dating stocks. As I dug through the data and tried to find which stocks could be winners, I came across a potential bombshell. All right, so you see the headline right here. Facebook dating launches today with a test in Colombia. This was on September of 2018. Facebook did announce that they were going to experiment with dating in May of 2018. As best as I can tell, in 2019, Facebook is not only still live in Colombia, but they've added another country as well. I believe it was Brazil, but it's escaping me at the moment. They have two foreign countries that are live with their dating app. There are not a lot of reviews or news stories about how that's going. I'm sure they're keeping it close to their vest. But as you can imagine, as we look at this from an investment standpoint, right, and we know how much of the market Match holds, we know that there's very few reasonable competitors out there in the stock market anyway. There are some options in private investment that could come online later if they ever go public. But right now, I would say it's Match versus Facebook, with Facebook being the big asterisk. That asterisk being, we don't know when Facebook is going to launch or if it will launch dating in the United States. We certainly don't know if it's going to be successful, but it is an intriguing play on the dating market, because when you invest with Facebook, if you think they can do well in dating, if there's any research that says that these tests are going well, now you have a chance, much like a Google or Amazon, to own a company that's going to make money in dating, but is also spread out with several other business interests. So that's something to look for. As of today, If you want to invest in dating stocks, I recommend the Match Group for a long-term hold, 3 to 5 years. Keep your eye on Facebook. And if you want to get into a very short-term play and roll the dice a little bit, try Spark Network. That's all I got for today. Hope you enjoyed this. Please like and share the channel. My name's Jeff Beers. I'll see you on the next video.